despite the fact that Cleopatra is an exceptionally long film at around 3 hours, it really is a spectacular film that has to be watched. So it was released in 1963 and it was directed and written by Mankiewicz and stars the fabulous Elizabeth Taylor and Richard Burton, as well as Rex Harrison. And this is obviously about Cleopatra, but I'll read the description from IMDb to kind of give you a little bit of overview of what it's actually about. Queen Cleopatra VII of Egypt experiences both triumph and tragedy as she attempts to resist the imperial ambitions of Rome. So we have a biopic about Cleopatra, and I'll be perfectly honest, I think this film is used as a source by many to get their information about Cleopatra, and I didn't know that much about her. I knew obviously the very basics. Having watched this, I feel a lot more informed. By no means do I feel like an expert, and I can't really vouch for the historical accuracy, but the fact that it's done so well over the years kind of suggests to me that it is at least somewhat accurate for people to continue loving it so much. Obviously, Elizabeth Taylor as Cleopatra is brilliant to see. Her performance is absolutely exquisite. She looks the part. She feels the part to me. And I guess she'll always be known as Cleopatra more than any other role. Richard Burton plays Mark Antony and he suits the role really well. Rex Harrison is Julius Caesar. I think out of all of them, Caesar is the one for whom I had the most clear image in my head. And I was not disappointed with that portrayal at all. It is long, as I said. I think for the most part, it kind of captures the attention really well. It doesn't drag too much. I think it's a film that you need an interval for. I'm not sure when it was shown in the cinemas, if there was an intermission, but I hope there was. But it is intense. There's a lot going on. There are a lot of names mentioned. If you're not familiar with this time period, as I was not too much, I think it's something that will need a couple of watches. But for the most part, I do think it's easy enough to follow. The set designs are incredible. Cleopatra's costumes are great. All of the costumes look really realistic and great. I don't have any issues there. The soundtrack is nice. It didn't stand out to me as being too amazing, but it's something that I did enjoy. The characters feel believable. If somebody knows how accurate they are compared to what we know for the real Cleopatra, that'd be really interesting to find out. But for me, from my expectations, I felt like they were realistic and believable enough. It's also an Oscar winner. It won the Best Cinematography, the Best Art Direction, Best Costume Design, and Best Effects. It didn't win Best Picture, which in hindsight surprises me. But then, I suppose a lot of great films don't necessarily. The film that won Best Picture was actually Tom Jones. It was also up against America, America, How the West Was Won, and Lilies of the Field. And I actually feel like How the West Was Won would have also been a really strong contender there. That's a really great film. There isn't anything about this film that I don't like. It's not my favourite film. I'm probably unlikely to watch it again from start to finish, because 3 hours for my little attention span doesn't go down well. But I was really impressed with the film. It is a great epic. I think they've done very well with this. Visually, it's incredible. The budget, if I can find this information, apparently it had an estimated budget of $44 million, which is more money than I could ever imagine. It is incredible. It's a triumph. It's a great success. It's a film everybody has to see at least once, maybe only once, unless you're particularly interested in this time period. But personally, I was nervous going into it, but I'm really quite pleased with it.